today. Welcome for joining me. We're just gonna take a time and a minute to breathe, to feel any tension in your body that you might require to stretch and breathe into. So the whole practice of yoga is about that, you know, self-care, taking care of areas in your body that you're storing stress. You know, we're living in a world that is constantly stressing us out, and we need to make sure that we're not just letting the stress to store in our body, but we release it. So it's really good to breathe and to stretch and to play around, and you know, any form of movement, either sports, dancing, or whatever is the best way to release the stress, you know, that's good. As long as we are not allowing any blockages and barriers in our body to store. Our nervous system, and the nervous system is all connected to every part of your body, and the fastest way to start is stretching your neck directly attaching to your brain is through your hands and arms, you know. So we're gonna do lots of hands to release the tension around the nerves from the muscles and tendons. So we start here, just stretching the hands, really simple. And as you feel the tension, you know, you exhale it and release it and relax. And there is a bunch of different layers, so we'll just go a little bit at a time, we relax, we release, and then we do it again to the other side. Notice the difference from what you did before. I'm just gonna go ahead and start stretching my hamstrings as I'm bending here. Inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, exhaling. And taking a deep inhale and opening your chest, looking up. If you're having a sedentary life and you're definitely feeling the tension in your neck and shoulders, moving your arms, opening your chest is gonna be, you know, in your shoulders, is gonna be the most beneficial for you. Deconstructing, you know, just like the posture, you know, we get used to such a posture that we kind of crystallize in place, so we gotta maintain a posture that unblocks what we've been doing, you know, the bad habits. So learning new habits, but even with the new habits and good posture, you still gotta make sure that you have elasticity and flexibility all around the spine. So you want to make sure that you're just playing in every single angle, sideways, forward, back. obviously forward bending, and thanks it really unblocks my spine. So this one is a really good one if you're wanting to release any tension on your lower back first by maintaining your feet locked, your hips on top of your feet, bending your knees, taking a deep breath, and then just maintaining your hips in one place and then moving your arms side to side. I like moving my hands up and down, and that helps me move the tension as I'm breathing and release it, vertebrae at a time. Middle back, lower back, middle back, upper back, and every in between the vertebrae. And as high as my arms go, the more I'm working on my neck. And the lower I go. You're doing the movement. So depending on how much tension you have, it's depending on how long you keep going, but the way that I'm doing this yoga classes is in a way that you are able to maintain the relaxed muscles and your nervous system kind of activated and released, so the energy can fully flow in and out. And yoga is a spiritual experience, as it really brings you back to your, you know, it connects your mind with your body, with your heart, with your emotions, with the present moment. So anything where you're living the present moment is in itself a spiritual experience. And navigating into this, living in the moments, is kind of living in the unknown and in between life, because you're not in the past or in the future, you're just in the moment. And that's where magic is. So as long as we're breathing consciously and just witnessing life in the way that it's going, and as soon as you start withdrawing from the environment and actually bringing your focus, you know, into your breath, into the movement, into your mind, and then if you're having a lot of thoughts and unable to control your mind, then you exhale it out. You know, as soon as they arrive, you let them out until you start really connecting and opening the space to actually embody the rest of your body, like all what you're feeling. So yeah, we're gonna keep breathing, sinking into the heart. And if you really know your nervous system, you know we have branches and roots from our feet, and like our head, it sprouts like the trees. And kinda like this. That's just like a whole entire brain, like rising upwards the sky. And we only see the outer part of the tree, and we don't see what's inside or how far it goes in the within the earth. So I like to picture myself as one tree and really sprouting myself as high as I can go beyond what we are being shown. As far as your mind can like reach out, you know, and as far as down as my body can reach out, and become just a vessel to just allow energy to flow through us freely. And if we have any blockages of, in different parts of our body, that will get released that will get, you know, that energy that we're activating and moving with our conscious mind, it starts flowing. And that's the whole point about yoga, to maintain an open, unconstricted body so that energy can flow and everything just works in the way it should. And again, if there is any pain, any areas, obviously be gentle with your body. And if there is, you know, it's a work in progress, but working where you're at, breathing and being persistent and just relaxing. Like the whole part and the whole beautiful aspect of yoga is like the more you relax, like it's just like the better energy will flow and other levels will unfold in itself. So I'm gonna keep doing yoga. And I'm gonna turn up this music here.
Bye.
hope that you guys have a beautiful day. Remember, if you're gonna be outside, you can just bring a jacket, some gloves. I didn't bring mine, but it's kind of amazing to still be outdoors and breathe some fresh air. And yeah, have a beautiful day.